Justin, how much of a difference do those shorthanded goals mean as far as momentum goes and just the attitude on the bench?
Yeah, those are always uplifting, you know, whether it's goals or killing penalties off. You know, I think especially teams can create momentum for us. So I think we just got to, you know, stick with it. We're doing a lot of good things. Obviously, our power play scored right away there with Furkey, and I thought our PK did a really good job. So those are momentum builders, whether you score sometimes or not.
How much can a goal like that help you? I mean, points haven't been where you wanted them to be, but to get a big emotional goal like that.
Yeah, I mean, you know, frankly, I'm just going to go out and continue to do it right. You know, obviously points are a big thing, but I think the process and doing things right, you know, each and every game. And, you know, you can't go out there and squeeze your stick too hard or worry about it. You know, you're going to have your ebbs and flows of a season, so you've got to make sure you're doing it right.
Is that what you've seen more of really since the Boston-Montreal trip as a team? I mean, you haven't won every game, but you've played much better considerably.
Yeah, I think we're, you know, we've faced some adversity, and that's never a bad thing. And I think we've grown as a hockey team. We're learning how to win this league and what it takes. And we got a good home stretch here, so we want to be good here.
Hey, Justin, what did that Carolina game do for you guys? It seems like after that game, you had like 3 days of practice. You lost the next one. It was a close one, though, and since then, winning.
Yeah, you know, I think we learned a lot from that Carolina game. I think, you know, they were really aggressive on the forecheck. They're deep pinch really hard, and we just turned a lot of pucks over in our own zone. We end up spending a ton of time down there, and they're obviously a team that shoots everything, but, you know, I think that was a lot of self-inflicted plays by us. So, you know, I think our D are doing a really good job of getting back to pucks, and forwards are getting in good spots, and we're trying to exit the zone as quick as we can, because once you're in the zone for 20, 25, 30 seconds, it makes it tough, and then you have no energy to go in the other zone and play. So we just got to continue to be fast out of our own zone and do things right.
Confidence is obviously a huge factor in this game. Now that Rasmussen's put a couple of pucks in the net, how have you seen his confidence grow overall?
Yeah, he's playing better each game. He's obviously a big and strong body that, you know, he made some good plays on the wall. And, you know, right in front of the net there, he made himself big and was strong on stick for that rebound. So he's doing a lot of good things, and he's growing as a player, and it's fun to watch.
Did that Glendening fight kind of spark the team a little bit? And even though they scored that early power play goal in the third, it seemed like you guys were really more aggressive.
Yeah, it was, you know, Glennie's just a hard-nosed player. He brings it each and every night, you know, whether he fights or not. You know, he'll stand up for himself, though, and that was good to see. It definitely got us on the bench going. I think it got the crowd a little excited and brings that old-school type hockey back that Tortorella was talking about. So.
It was kind of a
block,
too. I think there's two punches immediately went down.
Yeah, Glennie's a strong man. I mean, he's... You know, he played running back in high school. He's got that low center of gravity. He just drives through people. And, you know, he just, you know, I don't know if Mueller was ready for that. But yeah, Glennie holds his own. He gets in fights. He's done well. So it was good to see. Obviously, I think it did give us some energy. It gave the building some energy. So it was good for us.
Wait, it's good, too. I mean, you see that a lot on PKs. They may not result in a goal, but he or Helm drive it down the other end a lot.
Yeah, I mean, PK, you know, it's, you know, obviously you want to, you know, kill the penalties first, but, you know, we do have speed. Larks had an opportunity in the first there where the puck just didn't get by on the wall by the defenseman. It was close. That was probably another breakaway there, but anytime you can pressure them with speed, that can put the power play back on their heels. But you know, most importantly, you know, I think we want to kill the penalties first, but you know, when we get those opportunities, it's great to bury him.
Dylan's obviously been a good player for a while now, but do you feel like he's taken another step so far early on this year?
Yeah, you know what, that's last game, Columbus really stuck out for me. I mean, he really, obviously we're down to 10 forwards, but felt like he had a really good game. And you know, I think just as a group here, you can see, I think we're just more confident and making more plays, and we're doing a great job in the offensive zone, making plays. But yeah, like I said, Dylan, you know, I think he's starting to take his game to another level, and it's great to see, because he's, you know, he's got a great future ahead of him, and he just keeps working hard. He's just going to continue to get better.
Thanks, Abs.
Thank you.